In May 1979, it looked like the campaign may have to be fought all over again. Hogston, that little hamlet dwarfed by nearby Dunton, this time gave its name to the airport site.
To start the campaign off once again, a sale was held in the new school to raise funds. One of the sideshows proved a great attraction. Many posters were erected around the village. Volunteers gathered to paint a variety of signs against this destroyer of our environment.
The wearer bandwagon had started to roll again, and so had Jerry Smith-Cresswell's camera. TV crews were on hand, and it was a case of friends being reunited as folks flocked to the event. Desmond Fennell, chairman of Wearer, was back in action. So was Vice Chairman Bill Manning, strutting his strut. These are the only pictures that have surfaced to date of the rally that was held in Hogston to gain publicity and raise new funds for a likely costly campaign. Jerry's camera recorded no sound, so here it has been newly added. This time, Wearer had a different president, Professor Colin Buchanan. Its white knight of the earlier campaign became that president. Proudly, he said. The event did, of course, have to end up with a bonfire. to destroy this time the effigy of a bowler-hatted Whitehall planner. By December, the threat had gone.